Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In this additional video on the Connected Conform Workflow, we're going to take a look at the Flame 2019.1 update changes to managing time warps or speed changes when using multiple sequences in a Connected Conform. If you've never used the Connected Conform Workflow before, please watch the previous videos to take you through the whole workflow step by step. Now, this video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now, in terms of speed changes, speed ramps, or time warps, we've identified a few scenarios where this would cause a problem in previous versions of Flame. For example, in Flame 2019, even if you had the same shot with a speed change or time warp in every sequence, when it came to making the shot sequence, you would get duplicates of the same segment, which doesn't make any sense. This prevented segments with time warps from correctly linking and syncing in prior releases of Flame. Now that we're in the Flame 2019.1 update, things should be a little different. I have loaded three sequences that share the same media across all the timelines using a sources sequence. Now before I create the shot sequence for VFX work, I want to point out that in this case, the speed change is constant between all three sequences. In other words, the same segment in each sequence is running at half speed or 50%. So the speed is the same, but the starting frame and duration of each time warp segment is different. In the conform view, I'll create the shot sequence using the pull-down menu. When you take a good look at the newly created shots sequence, note that there is only one time warp segment and not multiple segments as in previous releases of Flame. So this is the longest instance of the segment, which has the 50% speed adjustment, and it's correctly linked to all the sequences in the Connected Conform. But what if the speed change or time warps were different in each of the sequences? For example, maybe each segment has a different speed change per sequence. This is what we have in the second example. So this segment's speed change is 75%. This segment's speed change is 50%. And the final segment's speed change is 125%. The source sequence currently collected all the media with no effects applied. Now when I switch to the Conform tab and create the shot sequence again, this time you'll end up with multiples of the same segment, but with different time warps. This ensures that no frames are missed due to the varying speed changes in each segment. So with different time warps, speed changes or speed ramps on each segment, the shots sequence will have multiple copies of the same segment, which matches the previous versions of Flame. However, I do have a great tip to prevent multiple time warp segments with the same media. Let's rewind back to the point where we've created and linked the sources sequence. Now, as a reminder, in this scenario, the same media in all the sequences have a speed change, but each speed change is different per sequence. Creating a shot sequence at this point will only result in multiple segments using the same media with different time warps. So as an alternative, let's focus on the sources sequence. Now the sources sequence is normally only about media. So this is all the media, including the shot before it is time warped in all the segments. So currently, the media is linked, but not any VFX or timeline effects on the segments. The tip is to select the segment that is affected by the different speed changes in the different sequences and create a source segment connection through the contextual menu. Ensure you apply it to all the sequences in the sequences reel. Looking at the segment, you now have a chain icon indicating the source segment connection. Now, since this is at the source media level, you can switch to the timeline view and you can apply any timeline effects to the segment. I'll reiterate that you're working with the original media before any time warp speed changes or speed ramps. Once you've made your effect, you need to sync it to all the connected segments in the other sequences. However, you need to be careful at this point. If you call up the contextual menu over the segment and choose to sync the segment connections, it will overwrite all the effects on any of the linked segments, and this includes the time warp timeline effects. So instead, call up the contextual menu over the 2D transform timeline effects and choose to sync it to the shared sources segments. This option will add other timeline effects to the linked segments, and it will not overwrite any time warp timeline effects. You may also get an animation error at this point, and this means that Flame cannot align any VFX animations because each clip is running at a different speed. So this may require manual tweaking. If you switch to a linked sequence and select the time warp timeline effects, the speeds should still be the same. And if you click through the different sequences, you'll note that each speed adjustment is different, but they all have the synced timeline effects that follows after the speed change. So how does this affect much more advanced compositing, such as using batch effects and node flow graphs? I'll undo all the timeline effects except for the time warps. Back in the sources sequence, I'll select the linked segment and apply a batch effects to it. So right now, we are working on the original media, which is unaffected by any time warps or speed changes. I'll quickly connect some custom nodes that I made earlier. This is a rough sky replacement. When we exit batch effects, the result is applied to the segment in the sources sequence, and this is running at normal speed. To sync this to the sequences that already have speed changes, you perform the same operation as before. Call up the contextual menu over the BFX and sync the batch effects to the shared sources segments. All the sequences update, and visually, they are all the same. However, in each instance, they are running at different speeds because of their respective time warp timeline effects. So as a quick summary, if the shot has the same speed change in every sequence, then the shot will only be created once in the shots sequence. However, if you have the same shot in each sequence, but the speed change is different per sequence, then you'll get multiple instances of the media with its time warp in the shots sequence. Or you can use the tip of syncing an effect using the source segment connection to get around the multiple instances. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.